Hey guys, Delia here. So today I wanted to talk about the two Japanese maples that we have in our backyard. And I'm sorry guys, it's a little drizzling right now, so I hope you don't mind the umbrella. But the first Japanese maple is right behind me and it is a magnificent specimen. So I posted a photo on Instagram and a couple of the Facebook pages and people just are blown away by this tree. Unfortunately, this year was not the best year for fall color, whether for this tree or any trees in our neighborhood. We had a hard frost quite early, so the leaves kind of got snipped and they turned this like crunchy dry leaves instead of like the full brilliant fall color that they usually are when we have milder fall. So I will be using footage from last year and show you the full glory of this tree and answer some questions. Now, people online ask me a lot of questions about this tree. How old is it? What kind of cultivar is it? And how do we take care of it? So I'm going to answer those questions one by one. Now, this tree is about 80 years old. And as you can see, it is incredibly slow growing tree because even for 80 years old, it is probably maybe 15, 18 feet tall. It is very wide tree, but it is not very tall. As for the cultivar, I do not know exact variety, and I have been struggling for years to find out the exact cultivar of this tree. I know it is an Acer palmatum dissectum, but I do not know the cultivar. I actually reached out to some of the Facebook group pages on Japanese maples to find out the cultivar, and they pretty much all said that it was impossible for them to identify it without actually looking at it. But as for the maintenance of this tree, it really is low maintenance once it's established. And at 80 years old, obviously this is a very established tree. It does not require any special watering. In northern New Jersey where we are, we get decent rainfall during the summer and actually all seasons. It does get sufficient moisture, so it does not need any supplemental watering. The only thing that I do is I kind of in the spring, early in the spring, I go around and I clean up all the dried branches that are obviously dead. And then we mulch around the tree probably around May time. So this tree is a four seasons tree for sure. If you're looking for a tree that is providing you with lots of interest all year round, this Japanese maple, and there are tons of cultivars that are kind of look the same. So it is Acer palmatum dissectum, as I mentioned, or also known as lace leaf maple. And there are hundreds of lace leaf maples, all different colors, and the dissection on the leaves vary. So they have a beautiful winter structure. Even with no leaves, those corkscrew-like branches and very contorted branches are amazing with like snow load on them. It's just beautiful. In the spring, they bloom with tiny red flowers. And actually under this particular tree, I have about 1,000 of snowdrops that I've been planting year after year. And I'm kind of building up my collection, and the display early in the spring is just gorgeous. And then in the summer, it actually is kind of like a maroon red color. It is not green. It is, I don't think it's evergreen. It's always some sort of a, like a red tone color. And then in the fall, of course, it's on fire. And actually every fall it varies from like a light yellow color to like a bright orange, fiery orange color. This tree likes to be planted in kind of like a semi-shade filtered sun location in my area, and they also like to be protected from harsh winds. And this is a perfect spot for it. Whoever planted it long, long time ago, thank you. And as for the pests or diseases, this is a very low maintenance tree. However, 2 years ago when I had my kind of a semi-annual tree checkup on my property, the arborist noticed that this tree had major scale infestation. And that's why I trust tree care to professionals, because I would have never known. Scale is so tiny, and it literally covered every branch and like every nook and cranny on this tree. So they actually had to come in and spray this tree for scale, and it treated it and it's fine. We're probably going to have to spray it next year because prophylactically. But I really trust tree experts when it comes to all trees, because I'm not an arborist and trees require kind of their own special care. And the local company that I use is Bartlett Tree Services. And if you're in New Jersey, I highly recommend them. I am not sponsored by them. I don't get any sort of compensation from them, but I do recommend them to my clients and to my friends and to anyone I know, because they are awesome. So I think this is it. As for this tree, oh, another thing, when I posted photos on the Instagram, and there are unbelievable photos that I took last year, a lot of people were like, oh my God, this is so postcard worthy, and you should totally frame this. And I did. I framed one of the photos of this tree last year, and it was actually Michael's Christmas present, and he was so happy. So let me move on to the other tree that we have in our backyard. Other Japanese maple that we have on our property is a bloodgood Japanese maple. And I'm sure you have heard about bloodgood Japanese maples before. They're quite common. But I just wanted to show you what the mature size looks like. So this tree is about the same age as the one I just showed you, which is about 80 years. And you can see that in 80 years, it actually matures in a decent size tree in my area. I don't know about the rest of the country. Now, this tree also very low maintenance, does not require any special care. Has beautiful purple leaves in the fall, and I will get a little bit closer to show you the leaves. But yes, I just wanted to show you, you know, what kind of a difference in growth rate in habit kind of the same species can have. All right, so unfortunately, there's no good way to show it because it's like against the light. I'm sorry, guys. But the leaf is this color. They usually turn this color in the fall, and you can see some of the other leaves right there. But they all just got like fried from the frost this year, unfortunately. All right, guys, I hope you enjoy looking at these beautiful Japanese maples, and note that right now is a good time to plant one in your garden, at least in my zone, zone 6, northern New Jersey. And as someone said, the best time to plant a tree is 30 years ago, and the next best time is now. So thank you so much, guys, for watching. If you have any questions or comments, post in the comment section below. I'll see you next time. Bye.